Halloween's coming up. Who's excited? I know I am. Let's put in the intro. Well, everybody, and welcome back yet to another video. Those who don't know who I am, my name is Timo Varakas, and I just said that in English. Varakas is how you actually pronounce it. Today, I'm here to discuss about 10 myths about photography. Let's get on with it. I got my own opinions on this. If you've got yours, just comment down below and tell me what you think about these myths. Let's get to it. The first one is, and there's actually three of them in this one because I think they kind of bundle up into one thing, and it's photography is easy. You get that a lot. After you pick up the camera and start photographing and maybe start doing it as a job, you'll probably start hearing the phrase photography is easy. It's a glamorous job and your camera takes nice pictures. Those are just nice to hear every time. If you're not a photographer, if you're watching this to learn about photography, it's not the camera that takes the picture, it's not a glamorous job, and it's not easy. First of all, if you're taking portraits, you should know some poses. That's a nice thing to do. When you're shooting with somebody, you just know what to tell them, what kind of pose to take. It's fun for you, it's fun for the model. Sometimes the models are actually pretty good. I suck at portrait photography. Actually, I think I take good portraits, but I don't know much about poses and telling the models what to do. But usually when I've worked with models, models are just, when they've done it a lot, they just know what to do. They listen to the shutter. I take a certain amount of shots, and after that, they change the pose. And another pose. And it makes the flow easier. And yeah, your camera takes good pictures. That's just, I can't explain that one. There's always a nice way to tell people just to tell them that it's you who's taking the pictures, not the camera. And it's not a glamorous job. If somebody tells you that photography might be glamorous and you're getting paid a lot, well, there's a lot of taxes and fees and equipment that you have to buy and pay. So it's not that glamorous. And usually the shooting is like 20% of the time. Business, post-processing, stuff like that, that's 80% of the time, pretty much. Now, the second thing is, the best brand is. There's always gonna be a photographer who's gonna tell you what the best brand is, but there isn't a best brand. There's a best brand for you, probably, but there's not a best brand that is just all around a best brand. There's good things in Nikon, there's good things in Sony, there's good things in Canon, there's good things in Fujifilm. There's different kind of photographers, there's different kind of cameras that people use, there's different kind of equipment. Something that might be good for someone other than for yourself. So what's the problem? Don't be rude to other people about their equipment because they're doing what they love just like you are. Now, number three is age is a barrier. It doesn't matter if you're young or old, if you have the strength to pick up the camera, press the shutter, that means that you're ready to learn and you're ready to take photos as much as you want. Of course, there is a learning process. It's a lifelong learning process. I am still learning. You're never gonna get perfect, even though you become a pro, even though you get paid. It's always a learning process. Pros don't take better photos than amateurs. I've seen a lot of people just pick up the camera, take a photo, put it in post-process, and damn boy, those pictures look awesome. Fourth thing is that photography requires expensive gear. Well, sort of yes or no. Cameras, of course, they can be expensive, but the best camera is the one you have. Looking at how much the phones have changed, what kind of cameras they have, you have probably a better camera in a pocket than somebody else. It doesn't matter what gear you have, it's the experience you get from shooting with that gear. It's what you do with it, it's what you learn from it, so make the most of it. At some point, you're gonna get better equipment, but that doesn't mean that it makes you a better photographer. Second of all, the equipment, of course, it gives you more of a variety on what kind of photos or video you're gonna do, but you can actually think about it. Does it kill your creativity or make it better? Just a thought here. And the fifth thing is spray and pray. No, don't do that. Don't spray and pray. Don't just go pressing down the shutter button and hoping that some picture is gonna be a good picture. First of all, that's gonna give you extra work in processing all the pictures, looking for that perfect shot. Second of all, you might be looking through hundreds, probably thousands of pictures and just realizing that none of them is actually that perfect. When you concentrate on taking a picture, just putting on manual settings, setting the ISO, setting the aperture, setting the shutter speed, you're gonna get a picture that you've dedicated your time to and probably a dope picture in the end. It's gonna be a banger. You just don't go spray and pray. Don't do that. That's not a good thing to do. You can always take a few photos of the same subject, and you should actually put a daily limit on how much photos you're gonna take. That means you're gonna actually put time and effort on taking those pictures. Now, when you pick up the camera, you're gonna probably get asked a lot that, do you have a permit? Well, that's a bummer question. You should check out the laws and the regulations in your country that defines the guidelines to photography. For example, in Finland, if you're shooting in public places, there's no problem. You can actually capture anybody in a picture and probably even release that picture to social media, onto magazines, onto anything without actually having consequences. But of course, you gotta have good taste. Don't put a picture of somebody doing stupid things that he or she wouldn't normally do. That's just not nice. Of course, you can always be nice and ask that, can you take a picture of that person? If you want a more detailed picture of that person or a portrait of that person. And talking about permits, of course, you're gonna need a permit when you're shooting in restricted areas or probably an event or a happening or some kind of festival or something like that. So always just check out the guidelines that festival has, because probably there might be restrictions on how to use a camera. And if you're starting photography and you realize that you're the one asking usually other people, or you have asked other people that, do you have a permit? Or maybe you don't have any idea about photography, you're just watching this to break some myths. The question, do you have a permit, is actually kind of attacking. For me, it feels that I'm doing something wrong, even though I might not be doing anything wrong. I might not need even a permit. It's just like people think that you need a permit. You can actually start a nice conversation that just ask what kind of picture the photographer is taking. What kind of pictures is he thinking of taking? And if there's something you don't like, then you can ask that, is there any kind of permits you need around here? Probably just take it to that direction, not just attack straight away that, do you have a permit? Because most of the time, the photographer isn't violating anybody or anybody's privacy, unless it's a paparazzi. So that's just, I don't even want to talk about paparazzis. I'd never be a paparazzi. Now, talking about permits and stuff like that, comes to mind drones. That's the eighth thing, drones. Shooting with drones, filming with drones might be a totally different thing. You might need another kind of permit. Actually, in Finland, we have to take a flying license course and do this internet test to get that flying license. And there's a myth that I want to break here, because actually I went to this private area once where was this viewpoint really high. The viewpoint was really high. And it was okay to photograph there, but you aren't allowed to fly any drones. I didn't know that you're not allowed to fly any drones, because it was just, photography is okay. You can take photos there. And there wasn't any signs, don't fly your drone or anything, and I just flew the drone up. And the owner came and asked me that, do I have a permit? Have I asked him for a permit? Because drones actually could film him picking his nose or something. And I didn't know how to tell him that the camera that I had in hand can actually take perfect photo of him picking his nose with the right lens, not the drone. We're not in a spy movie. They're not any kind of spy drones. They can't zoom in like that, that just look at you picking on your nose, because you'd have to fly really close and you'd hear it coming. No, you can't film or shoot a photo of somebody picking their nose without them seeing it coming. There you go, myth busted. Actually, the drones were the seventh thing. Or was it the eighth? No, it wasn't the seventh thing. So the eighth thing is now, and that is the weather sucks. You tell yourself you can't go take any photos because the weather sucks. That is a myth. You can always go shoot and you can always take photos. You can actually take pretty dope photos in a rainy weather. The reflections of puddles and the drops and everything just might make it even moody and different kind of photo that you're used to. You don't have to restrict yourself into golden hour. Just use mist and fog and everything like that. They're gonna give a totally different mood to that photo and they might actually look pretty dope and nice. Pro photographers do it full time. No, that is a myth I wanna bust. Of course, if you're doing good, you have a team, you have a studio, you have a name for yourself, locally or publicly or worldwide, you can do it full time. But usually when you're starting off, you're gonna probably do it with your day job. That's what I do right now. I'm actually doing 30-hour weeks right now. I've taken out some hours, so I have more time to do photography and take photographs. But yeah, that's a myth. Some people don't do it full time and it's okay. You don't have to do it full time. It doesn't make you any worse or any better of a photographer if you're doing full time or part time. Just remember to practice and always learn something new. And number 10, I want you to listen closely. Some people might tell you that post-processing is cheating. That's a load of bull. Photography is an art. I told you in my last video, I'm gonna tell you here, photography is an art. You don't go telling a painter or another artist, a pianist or something, or somebody else that I don't like how it sounds because it's not the way it's supposed to go. You can make variations of different things, of sceneries, of portraits. You can use Photoshop, make the moon bigger, make the sky more cloudier, just do a fake golden hour because you think that a golden hour would be perfect for this shot. It doesn't matter. You just make it look like it's yours. You don't make it out there by taking raws. You make it out there showing what you can do in post-processing. That's the way it goes nowadays. There might be somebody who likes to see more realistic stuff, and if he or she hires you, do more realistic stuff. But keep doing you. Just do you. Do whatever makes you feel better or good. And it's an art. It's an art form. That's what we do. We take photos. We do films. We're showing ourselves in those photos and films and everything. Here I am. This is me. I'm talking like I talk. This is me. You're looking at me. The dude wearing hoodies and a James Coffee Co. cap, trying to imitate a certain Canadian dude, probably. No, just actually I'm trying to look like him, not be like him. If you are thinking about a myth that you want to bust it down in the comments. If you like this video, you know what to do. Subscribe. Hit the bell icon to see more videos from me. I'll be seeing you on the next one. Good night, everybody.